Alright guys, just a quick introduction to this new series I'm doing. I'm a young barber, 18 years old. I'm a senior in high school. I'm about to go into barber school first thing out of high school. Right now I'm going around to the OGs of the game, the OG barbers of the game, the OG barber owners, and I'm just asking them to shed light of their wisdom to me. And I'm taking videos, so any young barbers coming up, you can watch these videos and you can learn on the same way as me, like all these young, all these OGs of the game shedding knowledge, like it can't hurt. And I got big plans for the barber game for the future, so yeah, that's pretty much it. Here we go, let's roll this video. Alright guys, this is on the way to Otis's barbershop. Otis is 65 years old. He's been in the game for like 30 years. He's got a lot of experience. He's a real OG, and so he's the first person I went to for this series. He has some great insight to give, and hopefully you guys will learn a lot, especially if you're planning to own a barbershop. This is a perfect video for you.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow, they're like much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself.
How old were you when you decided that you wanted to be a barber?
I was 35 years old before I ever went to barber school.
Really?
Yeah, I was an entertainer, played music all my life in bars around Columbus. And I was going to do that, and then all of a sudden, the disc jockeys and karaoke came along, and that ruined that, so I knew I was going to do something pretty, and it don't take long to go to barber school. You can be in and out of there for less than a year. I was 35 before I became a barber.
Wow.
That was 30 years ago.
Man. And have you ever had any regrets about becoming a barber?
No, not at all. I like what I'm doing right now better than anything I ever did, so I guess really this right here would probably be my chosen profession for what I would want to do now, because I'm here of a day, I'm home of a night, I get off about 7 o'clock, and I'm home of a night and don't have to be out, you know, after dark and staying out to 2 o'clock in the morning playing in bars. And
yeah.
I would imagine I wouldn't change anything at all about what I'm doing now.
How old were you when you opened the shop?
54.
Do you think it's possible to open the shop at 22?
Yes.
You're
possible. probably a lot better to open it at 22 than it would be at 54. Yes, that'd be very possible. Yeah, if somebody wants to do that, man, yeah, go for it, because of at 22, you would have a lot of friends to choose from that you're going to go to school with. And, oh, yeah, I would say definitely go for it, because you can get a lot. Yeah, there's more people out there that's going to help you than what you think.
Really?
Yeah, because if you say you want to do it, and you come in and you try, there's a lot of people that's going to be there that you don't even know about that's going to come in and get haircuts, and they'll tell other people. And, yeah, I'd say it'd be a wonderful profession for a young person to go into right now.
Do you prefer owning the shop as opposed to working in one?
Yes, much.
And why?
Much prefer. Why?
Yes.
Well, one thing now, me in particular, I guess I'm a person that was meant to work alone.
Mm-hmm.
And I love working by myself. Of course, you'd have to own a place to work by yourself. Mm-hmm.
Did you ever have problems with other barbers?
Yes.
Really?
Many.
Really?
Yeah, when you stand 10 hours a day next to somebody, you're going to have problems. No stories. But when you stand working next to somebody for 10 hours a day, 5 days a week, you're not going to get along real good.
Did you struggle starting out as an owner of the shop?
Yes. Yeah, it's, but like, I was 54 years old, so I've been working my entire life, so. It wasn't like I was destitute or anything like that to start. But yeah, the first year I was here, it was probably like 1-2 haircuts per day, and that went on for about the first year.
Did you have a clientele base before you owned, did that carry it over to this shop?
Very, very little. Because I had worked in several barber shops, but I really hadn't stayed in contact. But then actually through the years, people had found out through word of mouth or whatever, or calling my house or whatever, that where I was at. So yeah, I've got a lot of people that I've known from other shops that come in here.
How many cuts do you do a day now, on a good day?
On a good day, 25.
And on a slow day?
10.
So yeah, I'm doing too bad.
No.
How did you start picking up business?
Well, mainly word of mouth, and I had business cards and stuff. I handed them to everybody I seen.
Mm-hmm.
Just let everybody that you know that where you're at, and what you're doing. Little by little, like I say, there's more people out there that will help you than what you think.
Mm-hmm.
So just, it was like the first year, it was like 1-2 haircuts a day, and then all of a sudden the second year, it was almost Thanksgiving, and so people started coming in for haircuts. And it's held up ever since then. I've been here for 11 years now. So.
How did you keep paying the rent when you only had 2 people coming in per day?
Well, that's just where I've been working for so many years. You didn't have to worry.
You had money saved up?
Yeah.
Okay. And how much money did it take you to start up? Like, what would you say would it be a good number to start out with?
Yes, I was fortunate here, because when I came here, this room was empty. And nobody had been running it for a while, so I didn't have to buy a business.
Was this already a barbershop?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So all the sinks, all the mirrors, all the lights, and all the big stuff was here.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to bring in the barber chairs and my own equipment. I've got a very good price here, but then if you go like to a major shopping center or something like that,
it's going to be more?
Good grief, yes. Mm-hmm. It'd be tremendous what you pay at some place. But I'm really fortunate here because of I don't have to pay a whole
lot. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to make a new video soon, so make sure you keep posted. That was just the first episode, so that's just a little taste of what's coming. Thanks for watching, guys.